we now discuss the solution of the problem from the section analysis. And the problem is on Riemann sums. This problem has appeared in CSIR National Eligibility Test held on 30th November 2020. And it is from the section C. The problem is, consider the identity function f of x is equal to x on the closed and bounded unit interval I is equal to 0, 1. Let Pn be the partition that divides I into n equal parts. If u of f, Pn and L of f, Pn are the upper and lower Riemann sums respectively, and An is equal to u of f, Pn minus L of f, Pn, then the four options are given to us. And option 1, limit n tends to infinity n a n is 0. Option 2, sigma n is equal to 1 to infinity a n is convergent. Option 3, a n is strictly monotonically decreasing. Option 4, sigma n is equal to 1 to infinity a n into a n plus 1 is equal to 1. We now discuss the solution of the problem in detail, and we are given the identity function f of x is equal to x defined on the closed and bounded unit interval 0, 1, that is the I. Now, it is given the Pn is the partition that divides the interval I into n equal parts. And the I is of length 1, and it is divided into n equal parts, and each part is of length 1 by n. And hence, Pn is 0 is equal to x0, comma x1, comma x2, comma etc., xi minus 1, comma xi, comma etc., comma xn minus 1, comma xn is equal to 1, where xi is I by n, and I takes the values 0, 1, 2, n. And that is, Pn is 0, 1 by n, 2 by n, 3 by n, n minus 1 by n by n is 1. Now, u of f, Pn is upper Riemann sum, and it is defined as sigma I is equal to 1 to n capital Mi delta xi, and L of f, Pn is lower Riemann sum. It is defined as sigma I is equal to 1 to n small mi into delta xi, where capital Mi is the supremum on the subinterval, supremum of fx on the subinterval xi minus 1 to xi, and the supremum of f of x is x, that is the identity function on the subinterval xi minus 1 to xi, is the right end point, that is xi, that is xi, that is precisely I by n. Similarly, mi is the infimum taken on the subinterval xi minus 1 to xi of the function f of x is equal to x, and the infimum will be the leftmost point, that is xi minus 1, that is I minus 1 by n. And delta xi is the length of the ith subinterval, that is xi minus 1 to xi minus 1, and it is of length 1 by n. Now, u of Pn, L of Pn we have written, and capital Mi, small mi, and delta xi, we all know these values. Therefore, u of f, Pn is sigma I is equal to 1 to n capital Mi delta xi, and sigma I is equal to 1 to n I by n into delta xi is 1 by n, that will be equal to 1 by n square into sigma I is equal to 1 to n I. And similarly, the lower Riemann sum L of f, Pn is equal to sigma I is equal to 1 to n, the lowercase mi, into delta xi, and that is equal to sigma I is equal to 1 to n I minus 1 by n into 1 by n, that is 1 by n square to sigma I is equal to 1 to n I minus 1. Now we compute a n, that is u of p n minus l of p n, and write down u of p n and l of p n here and simplify, we'll get 1 by n square into sigma I is equal to 1 to n 1. When 1 is added to 1 n times, and it will give you n, and that is equal to 1 by n square into n, that is 1 by n. So a n is 1 by n. We are ready now to discuss about the statements given in the options. We have a n, that is equal to 1 by n, and option 1, limit n tends to infinity n times a n is equal to 0. And now limit n tends to infinity n times a n, limit n tends to infinity n times a n is 1 by n, and n cancels, and the limit is 1, which is not equal to 0. And hence, the option 1 is not true. Now let's get into the option 2. Sigma n is equal to 1 to infinity a n is convergent. Now sigma n is equal to 1 to infinity a n is sigma n is equal to 1 to infinity 1 by n. Very clearly that we all know that this series is divergent. You can use the p series test, that is sigma n is equal to 1 to infinity 1 by n to the power of p is convergent if p greater than 1 and is divergent if p less than or equal to 1. Here p is equal to 1, and hence sigma n is equal to 1 to infinity 1 by n is divergent, that is sigma n is equal to 1 to infinity a n is divergent, and it is given to be convergent, and hence option 2 is not true. Now option 3, a n is strictly monotonically decreasing, and a n is 1 by n is clearly it is a strictly monotonically decreasing sequence, because 1 by n plus 1 is less than 1 by n for all n belongs to n, that is a n plus 1 is less than a n for all n belongs to n, and hence it is a strictly monotonically decreasing sequence, and hence the option 3 is true. We continue and discuss about the statement that is given in option 4. So, and option 4, that is sigma n is equal to 1 to infinity a n into a n plus 1 is 1. Now sigma n is equal to 1 to infinity a n into a n plus 1 is sigma n is equal to 1 to infinity a n is 1 by n into a n plus 1 is 1 by n plus 1. And this 1 by n into n plus 1 can be written as 1 by n minus 1 by n plus 1. And thus the sigma n is equal to 1 to infinity a n into a n plus 1 is equal to sigma n is equal to 1 to infinity 1 by n minus 1 by n plus 1. These are known as the telescopic series. Agreed. Now to discuss about the convergence, and we have to show that it converges and converges to 1. Is it true? That's what we wanted. To talk about its convergent, let us take the nth partial sum. Sn is the nth partial sum. That is the sum of the first n terms. That is equal to the first term plus the second term, the third term, the n minus 1th term, and the nth term. And clearly 1 by 2, 1 by 2 cancels, 1 by 3, 1 by 3 cancels, 1 by 4, 1 by 4 cancels, 1 by n minus 1, 1 by n minus 1 cancels, 1 by n, 1 by n cancels. We are left with 1 minus 1 by n plus 1. And let us take the limit n tends to of Sn, that is limit n tends to root of 1 minus 1 by n plus 1, that is equal to 1. Thus, the sequence of nth partial sums converges and converges to 1. Therefore, the given series is converges to 1. Therefore, sigma n is equal to 1 to infinity a n into a n plus 1 converges and converges to 1. Therefore, sigma n is equal to 1 to infinity a n into a n plus 1 is 1, which is true. The option 4 is true. Thus, the option 4 is true. So, in all, we have proved option 3 is true and option 4 is true. So, our final answer is the options 3 and 4 are true. That is the discussion of the solution of the problem from the section analysis, and the problem is on Riemann sums from the subsection. subsection Riemann integrals. And I am sure that you have understood the solution of this problem and go on working out some more problems on these lines. Thank you.